Yeah, that's what she ordered hers.
It's a robe.
Talking about jewelry, please.
No, I don't. Really
yeah. Like, yeah, they're so pretty.
Oh, aren't they so sweet? We actually have to take them. Give them to Jen. Give them to Mary. I'm also like that. They're
how did you start?
Oh wait, there's nothing there.
That's
because they have eyelashes.
Exactly.
I don't have any of them. Yeah.
She deserves all the pampering.
I think he's excited.
Yeah. It's both of us the center of attention. We're both super excited to marry each other. It's like the ceremony part. And once that's done, we're both going to be like, ooh.
That's how I am too. Yeah. I told Steven.
It's
I was like I can't
walking
do my own
down back. And being like the center of attention for
I
me
could
is
never
like,
do my own back.
Yeah. Are you happy, Mom? Getting like super nervous as soon as she started doing my hair.
Both hands in there. Tighten it up.
Well, she told me to look that way.
I know.
Yeah. What room you're in.
The bed.
Okay, Blair and Matt, so
everybody
over here.
This one really hard, Ryan. Like,
you got it?
I know it's on brick. You got it. Okay, perfect. You guys can go put that stuff
in your natural bag.
Just do
I'm having struggle in here.
Corey, just turn towards me.
Where's Jenny in the boathouse? Nice dress.
I'm
Good job, Dallas.
Jennifer and Ryan. And we thank God. And I thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In marriage, husband and wife give themselves to each other, to care for each other in good times and in bad. It is a way of life that all should reverence and none should lightly undertake. If anyone present knows a reason why Jennifer and Ryan may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Oh, John, I'm going to read. Please.
Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three. And the greatest of these is love.
Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Above all, clothe yourself with love, teach and admonish one another in all your wisdom. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I invite the congregation to please be seated. Ryan, will you give yourself to Jennifer to be her husband, to love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others to be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Stutter there.
Jennifer, will you give yourself to Ryan to be his wife, to love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others to be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
We are all children of God, his creation. John, Julia, Kevin, Jill, parents of Jennifer and Ryan, do you give your blessing to this marriage?
We do.
Thank you. Please remain standing. I'd ask the rest of the congregation to please stand as well. One of you here, by your very presence, has signified your love and support. That is who you are in their lives. And so now I ask you before God, will all of you who witness these vows now being made do everything in your power to uphold and support Jennifer and Ryan in their marriage? Will you say that so they can hear it?
We will.
That is awesome. You may be seated.
Hi, Ryan.
Take you, Jennifer,
to be my wife. To have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, for the rest of our lives,
according to God's holy law. This is my solemn vow.
To be my husband,
to have and to hold,
this day forward, for better for worse,
for richer for poor,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
for the rest of our lives,
according to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
Bless these rings, given and received, that they may be a symbol of the vow and covenant Jennifer and Ryan have made this day.
Yeah.
Jennifer, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of God. Amen.
Okay.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am,
and all that I have,
I honor you.
In the name of God. Amen.
May all those who have witnessed these vows find their lives and loves strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And I invite Ryan and James' fathers, who will be signing the register to join us. We come to the part where we bless the marriage. The blessing is chosen by the couple. That their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless, preserve, and keep you. We come to the part of the service from whence we get the term tying the knot. In the old days, the priest's shawl was taken off and tied around the wrists of both the bride and the groom in a tight knot. It was not untied until after the wedding feast.
That's going to be a problem for me.
That if the groom would eat, the bride must feed him. If the bride would eat, the groom must feed her. Interdependent for sustenance, as interdependent as one in the Lord. Ryan and Jennifer have joined themselves to each other by solemn vows, signified by the joining of hands and the exchanging of rings. I declare that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
Amen.
Amen. And it is my very great pleasure to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Jennifer Chilvers.
Your eyes look up at me, Jen.
I think there's no. The whole idea is to work. When she was old enough to participate in sports, over the course of 5 years or so, we enrolled Jen in soccer, karate, gymnastics, synchronized swimming, skiing, ballet, other forms of dance, and swimming lessons. Like most parents, we believed team sports would be good for Jen, but she was more interested in socializing than competing. She loved dance and still does, and she recently took tap dancing lessons, but competitive sports, including swimming, was just not in Jen's wheelhouse. It's all good though, because Jen, following Jen's fourth attempt at getting her maroon swimming badge, we put in a pool because it was cheaper! Julie and I are beyond proud of Jen for her determination and her enduring faith. She knew that one day she would be given full-time status in her field, and to remind her of her convictions, she has many framed expressions on her kitchen wall, one of which reads, "Faith is being sure of what you hope for." Well, last year, Jen's faith and staying power paid off. She's now a full-time ECE for the Trillium Lakeland School Board. Hallelujah! EA. Sorry, EA. I've been corrected. In closing, yes, I'm closing. Thank you for being such a wonderful, giving, thoughtful, bright, and cheery daughter, and for giving us, Jennifer, so many cherished memories. Brian, I know I speak for Julie too. Do I speak for Julie too? Yes. It puts a smile on our face knowing you're now our son-in-law. Kevin and Jill, thank you for loving Jennifer for over the last 4 years. Where are you, Jenna, Kevin, and Dick? God love you. And for all your help getting Ryan and her to this day, the buck and dough included, thank you. Let's now all raise our glasses and toasting Ryan and Jen Chilman!
I too endured many hours of labor
over
Ryan.
28 hours,
a
bunch of rubbing my back, please. Anyways, I usually do most of the speaking for the family, and my kids tell me that all the time, but tonight I'm going to do something different. I'm going to let my wife talk about her little baby boy. First off, I'd like to thank everyone for coming and enjoying a beautiful ceremony at John and Julie's place, and it was just amazing what they did at the house and all you people there, and it was just great. And I was only in charge of the weather, and I thought I did a pretty good job. thank you very much. And Jen, I'm going to welcome you in our family. You always were anyways, because you took Ryan away, and he's not living at home anymore, so I'm sorry. But he's found his... No, Gordon is over there, yeah. That's my next role. Anyways, Jen, Ryan, we found a real soulmate in Jen, and we are so proud of both of you, and we wish you all the best, and you guys are going to be just fantastic together, and we had a great day today, and we're going to have a great day. Okay, so now, I'm going to turn this over to Jill, and she's going to talk about her little baby boy.
Now, Ryan actually was a dream child. He was, really.
Yeah.
He slept through the night at 2 months, ate well, slept well, played well. We never had any issues with Ryan. He was just that quiet, nice little boy. Maybe had something to do with being surrounded by three sisters. But Ryan spent a lot of time watching sports and playing his games and just being by himself. Very, very quiet. He had a core group of friends from childhood, really strong friendship, as many of them are still here today. Matt, Adam, Tony, Eric. They went all through public school, high school, and they're still friends now. So I think that's a true character friendship there. Good group of boys. mean, boys are boys, but as I said, Ryan didn't give us much grief at all, if you don't count the one night he came home on New Year's Eve in a police car. And we, of course, are sitting there looking at this police car outside our house, thinking, Josh McWilliams, what's going on? Lo and behold, it's Ryan Chilvers. There was a time in his early 20s that I thought possibly Ryan would live at home with us forever. And I have to admit, I was quite fine with that. Not a problem. But I'm happy that, you know, the person he has choose to leave me for is Jennifer, the lovely Jen. I wish you nothing but love and happiness. Jen, take care of my boy. Thank you.
I was finishing up Teachers College in my last placement and she was an EA in that classroom. Although it has only been about 6 years, it feels like a lifetime. Jen and I became friends rather quickly and learned a lot about each other. Likes and dislikes, future aspirations, goals, and much more. We had a lot of common interests and quickly began to rely on each other when things were hard or didn't go right. I have a lot of great memories with Jen and would be here all night if I went through them all. We had a lot of adventures from dance parties in the car, singing at the top of our lungs, girl nights, and just men sessions. When Jen met Ryan, it was like a weight lifted. She found someone she saw herself spending her life with, and this continued to grow as time went on. They fit together well, and because of this, developed a strong friendship and a relationship. Ryan, thank you for making her smile and being there for her through all of the ups and the downs. I'm very blessed to be a part of your special day, and I hope that it is everything you imagine more. Of course, my speech as a teacher wouldn't be complete without a Dr. Seuss quote, so here it goes. We are all a little weird, and life is a little weird, and when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with ours, we join up with them and follow mutual weirdness and call it love.
Jen is one of your best friends. I couldn't be happier to celebrate this day with you. I am honored to stand by your side. Today could not have been more perfect. You look absolutely stunning. Ryan, you got lucky. Although, I barely recognize you without your Jay sweater and your Lisa. For as long as I've known Jen, I've pretty much known Ryan. Since the two became a couple, I spent every New Year's with both. So many memories I will cherish forever, and so many more to come. Yes, Ryan, that means you haven't gotten rid of me yet, and I'll forever be your third wheel. I'm so happy you found each other. Throughout life, you will meet one person who is like any other. You can talk to this person for hours and never get bored. You can tell them things and they won't judge you. This person is your soulmate, your best friend. Don't ever let them go. Congratulations, Jen and Ryan, for tying the knot today. Now. Before I'm done, I would like to tell you the story of Jen and Ryan and how they came to be. Boys, get up here. Back up, dancers! Better put a ring on.
portion of you know me, but for those who don't, I'm Adam, one half of the Best Man. But I think we can all agree the real showstopper here today was Jen. You look absolutely stunning. I've known Ryan for as long as I can remember. We went to school together for our whole lives, and have remained extremely close ever since. From biking all day to the summer, to sitting in the children's basement playing Mario Party.
Yeah.
Get the blisters on our palms from that rowing game.
I'm sure that's what you got.
Brutal. To Chili breaking his leg in public school. I wasn't there that day. I think I was faking sick. But I definitely heard about it that night on ICQ. We've been through a lot together and I cherish all our memories. I obviously haven't known Jen for as long as Ryan, but what I do know is that Jen makes Ryan happier than I've ever seen him and makes him the best version of himself. They truly are soulmates. Jen, if you would, please place your hand on the table. Doesn't matter. Ryan, I'd like to ask you to place your hand on your beautiful wife's hand. Now, everyone, I'd like to ask for a moment of silence. This is for you, Ryan. Enjoy it, cherish it, savor it, because it's the last upper hand you're ever going to have.
Down on you today, and they'd be so proud of you.
Jen, I'm so happy to call you a sister. I may have 6 sisters already, but my lucky number is 7, so I feel really blessed.
Loving, and she's everything I am.
Thank you.